stop the engine. Don't burn it up. Let me try to pull you out. We've just pumped up the tires with the compressor here that goes directly to the bike. And then tomorrow it's going to happen. We're actually going to go on a trip to Mount Rainier, back of Mount Rainier. And then, okay, we are, after years of preparation, well, since January actually, ready to go, ready to roll, packed and ready to go to the mountains. So Scott McLaughlin, I wish you were here. Walk around. Walk around. Ready to roll. So, good day of riding. We're now here close to Peckwood, waiting for Kevin to show up. As you can see, I found a nice spot under a bridge. What's that song? Under the bridge. And I was thinking to go for a swim, but it's very steep here and I'm not sure. There's some residential areas here, so I... Hey everybody, we're out here in the wilderness and trusted steed, the 114. Of course, the Dutch Bosboer, the fuel boss, needs to have a extra tank of fuel, because that's what I did in the army. I was boss is benzine olie, smear olie, which means fuel, kerosene, and all kinds of lubrication oils. So this is my new DAF, and I have a gallon of fuel here. So I'm the Bosboer, which is called the fuel farmer. That was my job, and that's why I felt so comfortable getting this bike. It's a little bit like a army bike. So when I was riding around in Germany, in the steppe of Germany, to fend off the Russians with my rolling fuel bomb, that was my job. And successfully, of course, because how many Russians do you see in Europe or London? Quite a few. Only the rich ones. Something's coming overhead here. It's a helicopter. And then people from the Netherlands, you're welcome to come riding. I'll organize some routes and some trips. You just rent a bike here and off we go. So everybody's welcome to join for some trips. Okay, signing off. And go. 3, 2, 1. Scott said bring a little wee thing for your thing. So we're standing again.
This is the early morning wake up scenario. Warming up the bikes and getting ready.
Okay, here we go. We've got the crew together. Kai on his insane machine. Likely the coolest of all. Lightest for sure. And then here's the tank. The supply.
Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good.
Coolant's
coming out.
Do you think it's just overflow?
No. This thing, something's not happy there. Oh dear.
Yeah, that's a problem.
I mean, is that something you made for this trip?
No, I didn't make that for this trip. This is a,
actually a sensor for the cooler.
So the first breakdown occurred after the climb. We're kind of on top now of the first climb, and I can recommend it. It is beautiful, a little bumpy, but a normal gravel road. What's that?
Are we all at the top? It's kind of weird, like the grain is like a helical shape too.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Why would it grow like that?
Literally, the winds of time?
Yeah.
Something like that, I don't know.
That's very poetic.
Very poetic, I'm trying. Cattle wreck downhill because we have a broken radiator, so we're heading south. I guess it's south, not quite sure. Just coasting down the hill here in section 2.
Well, you guys should turn around. I'll make it down for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, that's actually not a bad idea. Okay, another little stop to fetch our windshield. We decided to turn around and guess what we found? Our windshield! Oh look, I already have dust on my phone. Hurrah! Good stuff. Woohoo! A little bumpy. You gotta stand up, baby. Let me see you. Legendary James Brown. Woohoo! Okay, little break. Little break. Turn off systems. All systems shut down. Puddle.
Anybody here? So this is my cranberry juice that I carry on my back. And here we have some snow. It's serious business.
That was against my, that rock hit my motor block. I want to piece in shit. The motorbike will keep going straight, it's just your fear that's in the way. You go where I'm looking. And I keep hitting those rocks because I'm looking at it. That was a pretty gnarly climb right there. You gotta just sit down and run it, I guess. That's the scare away the scary people. I don't know, I'm mentally, this is a mental thing, where your fear of heights and your fear of speed climb over these, fly over these things and grab the things so you don't leave in your hands. But it's a mental, there's an aspect of mental gaming play here that is Dutchman with heights. We're definitely doing the climb now. And I just gotta roll with it and tickle my buddy behind me. We're good. We can do this. We're getting close to altitude. We need to feel a little bit sharper. Little chipmunk. So cute. The Tichy Boots would say. Tichy Boots stays calm. Holy moly. We're up pretty high now. And we're going straight. Actually, it does say straight, yes. Tower. Oh, there's a tower here. Okay. You go to the tower. Ah! Time for a video. Gotta turn my bike around here. Well, that was the epic climb, I guess. I'm just gonna go back to meet him over there. This is Dutchman versus altitude. Great combination. And back we go. Look at the dam over there. Dam! That's a good dam. Here we have some more GoPro flying. You can go to the tower. I think we're at altitude. I think this is this shot. I think we made it.
Yeah, this is prime drone shot territory here.
This looks like the top, right?
Yeah. This is as high as it goes.
How did you like that road?
Great. That's very exciting.
A little bumpy, huh?
It's gonna be a great test of the GoPro anti-shake.
Exactly. Let me take a.
I take off.
Yeah, man, it's getting warm.
It's a dramatic temperature swing. For now, I'll just leave a few little rounds and hope that does it.
Okay, here we go. We have replenished ourselves and we're riding the cliff. I don't know if it gets more scary than this, but so far, so good. Oh, here's some interesting rocks. Okay. This is more like trail stuff, I think. I'm not going to gun it over this shit. Whoa! Trail stuff. Slow. So Kai made it home safe. He's down there somewhere. Oh, yeah. This is really fun. Lots of hobbles. Hope my bags are still on there. But what I love is that it's not so close. Wait. Wait. I don't know, man. This one scares me, these cliffs. I'm just staying far away from the cliff. Oh, okay, this is a little bypass to the other road. hobbelige weg, op een hobbelige weg. Ah, puddle! Woohoo! I don't have wet socks anymore, so I'm going to take it easy for this one. And I have wet socks. These boots are made for, well, not for going through puddles with. Because it's apparently, they ain't watertight. Well, cheap stuff. Dutch guy buys cheap stuff. Oh, look, here you see the whole route we're going to be taking. Oh boy, this is just trial stuff. I don't want to force it on my bike. Just going to slowly trial over the stop. Find your path. Yeah, so to give the bike a little bit of a breezer through here. And this is apparently technically okie dokie hokey pokey. Grab that temperature and a lot of puddle. Could be deceptive. Never know what you're going to get. That is snow. That was the snow right there. We just did it. Is there snow? The answer is yes. It's in the form of liquid on June 18. Juneteenth, people. May we celebrate the Black Lives Matter. And the question is, why do we even have to ask that question? That's the shocking part, right? On Juneteenth in America. But it's a national holiday, so we definitely, let me see if I'm on track. Yep. So there's like a forest on top of the cliff. We definitely are now grateful that this is a national holiday and that there's attention on this history of African Americans. And there's still a long way to go because it's disgraceful that we have to say that Black Lives Matter. So Juneteenth, everybody. Love and peace. Love and peace to your fellow man. I had a dream. Oh, bypass. This is incredible. But it is trials riding because I really don't want to gun it over these rocks, to be honest with you. Gonna take it a little easier. Oh, this is so cool. Look at these little woods. If a bear cometh out, I shall be prepared. I hope. Look at this. Go over these stronken mensen. It's basically doing trials at altitude. We're still climbing here. A puddle! Hurrah! Little puddle. I don't know if this comes across in the video, but I had a massive streak of mud on the lens when I did that cobbler's climb. Kevin takes every viewpoint and goes and takes his drone out, so we gotta, which is admirable. I think this is almost the tip. I think I'm gonna ride to the tip and then stop there. I can see the villages. We're safe, there's a village on the other side. Oh, I'm getting giddy now with this riding, man. This is Scott. You gotta come out here, man. This is insane. Paul, you're gonna love it. We're just gonna go slowly and camp up here, and then everybody from the Netherlands who would like to join, I welcome you on this Bart and Zen on a motorcycle adventures, and I will take you up here. We'll rent a bike for you and we'll camp right here. And as you can see, I'm now gunning it to Thelma and Louise. This is the Thelma and oh boy, Dutch guy's getting wary. Thelma and Louise grid. How dare do you go? How close dare you go? Ah, I didn't dare closer. I'm just, I wouldn't say Sheila, because that's, these days you're not allowed to say that anymore. Apart from Australia. G'day, mate. Come on, you Sheila. And there comes Mr. Puddle Shot. It's the Thelma and Louise clip. It's the Thelma and Louise clip. No, no. Hold it. Oh, he's there. He's way more dairy than I am. This is the Thelma and Louise clip.
Oh, yeah. I'm glad the brakes work.
Wait a minute. You're missing it.
Yeah, I broke it off.
There's something. I thought it was an innovation.
No, next stop, we need to pick up some new sunglasses now.
I got a pair for you.
Oh, well, I don't need it right now.
Opening shot of the movie. And 3, 2, 1, go.
Wow, what a campsite, huh?
That was my opening shot for the movie.
That's something.
Okay, Kevin.
Hey, team.
So we made it?
Yeah.
We didn't have a lot of casualties on the way?
We didn't, not yet.
Just still on.
stuff falling off the bike. We didn't lose drones yet. We lost visors.
I actually thought I lost my camera just now. I was like, oh, man. I mean, not my camera, my phone. I'm like, oh.
We can always go back. It's just down the road. So 20 years ago, Kevin and I worked at Inside together.
That's right. Inside represent.
Inside represent. We're here on top of the mountain, still alive and kicking. And don't go so close to that cliff.
Wow, it's a long way down.
You're definitely not Dutch. Oh. What are these little plants here?
Oh.
Little fly riding again. Very bumpy stuff. That's super spiky rocks. I'm gonna get a puncture rolling along. That was the ABS kicking in. We need to bank a little bit here. And nice slide there, sliding straight. I slid out.
That was a little, glad the edge of the cliff isn't right there.
Yeah, it was right in between those trees. Yeah. Good catch. Thing's heavy though. Start sliding in those puddles. Do that on the edge of the cliff, huh? It felt more scary than that it actually was, but I literally just started braking in a slippery hill and lost it. I don't want to do that at a high speed. The bike has so much momentum that it just keeps sliding. This thing's heavy. I need to get even lighter, I think. But you can always park it in between the little bush and you're totally fine. Controlled maneuvers. Oop-da. I'm gonna come out of this vista again. And a little, something's on the car in front of me, but through here. This is definitely back to my army days as a bush, I call it boss board, fuel truck guy. Guess what? I forgot the fuel this morning. Ha! Puddle! So what this puddle is, you get the bike wet, which is fine. You get your boots wet, which is fine, but if you do the bank, you slide right in the middle, the front wheel. So a puddle in a bank is a risky business. I'm just trying to get meander my way through here. And puddles, and you can't see anything in the shade. So here we go, right over the middle. And you see the Hemi can really take, and there's this same situation, sliding sideways within a giant trough with wet is a bit risky. Oh, don't look down. Dutchman on a cliff could be the name of my website for adventure riding, because I'm mentally on a cliff. physically on a cliff. Where's he? I lost my wingman's doing some. DahlQuist is doing some. It's not Stig DahlQuist. We should call him Stig DahlQuist. He's doing some serious videoing, but I think he's out of batteries. I'm not sure what. Okay, tricky area with snow. The fun part is you have snow in liquid formation and it's actually melted. And it makes it even more funner than without it. And I'm not thinking about bears at all, by the way. Oh, massive rock here. Oh, trials riding. God dang it. Hang it. No cursing on the channel. Now here we go. I'm going to round it on a bank. If this bank is slippery and you're going straight and not in a corner, you're going to be sliding your front wheel right inside. I'm hearing Brad Tech in the back of my mind. Those amazing videos of Brad Tech are worth it, people. Go download it. It's hard to work this new job adventure school can be called. Oh man, this is just rocks over here. It's very slow going. Oh, it's shaky images. I don't think it's a boost. Snow! Ha! It's this way.
it. I don't want to do that crazy stuff where I get stuck in the mud to bike. Is this the Washington backcountry ride or what is this? It's more of a trials ride here. Muddy waters, man. Holy. Okay. This is what they mean with snow. This is called adventure riding. I'm going around it, man. It's very slippery. Holy. Okay, I think we're through. It's all snow. Snow waters. What? Kidding me? You can go there. Holy mom, man, this is technical stuff. It's crazy. Gotta go circumnavigate the snow here. We got stuck, we're screwed, man. It's gotten worse rather rapidly. Pretty intense. I hope that's the last of it. Man, this is all the snow stuff, right?
That was crazy.
Yeah. I don't want to get stuck.
Yeah.
I think this is the route. Okay. Really treacherous stuff. Not sure. I'm gonna go do this. Okay, I did it again. Damn.
Well, at least you have a helper now this time around.
Do you think we can make it through?
It looks like it's lightening up after.
Fun. Got the light from the machine, so I won't be able to keep up with him, I don't think. Well, there's no rocks. No rocks here, so I'm a little faster. I'm no cameraman. I'm trying to keep up with my... I can do it. Done it. There's no rocks here. There's Mr. Blomqvist. Stig DahlQuist from Norway. On the bike here in front of me. It is now currently in lead, as you can see, with Bart Zen and the Art of Bart following closely behind. And it's Verstappen. And he's out bruising in the corner and there's, oh no, there's rocks. He chose to dirty with the crowd. And there are rocks, people. You have to catch up down the straight with DCS, DCR down, whatever that thing's on the back, the wing, the floppy. Oh, this is good. Oh boy. And mud! We got mud, people. Very excited. Oh yeah! I'm not gonna do that. I'm being civil here. Hey, actually, we gotta go that way. No, don't do it. I'm gonna get stuck. You need these pants for 3 days. Don't burn up the engine, dude. This is what happens. Just pull them out. Thank you. Hold on. Don't burn up the engine. Don't burn it up. Let me try to pull you out. Are you out?
Yeah, that was awesome.
That was awesome, man. I said, don't do it. Now. These pens are made for 3 days.
Oh, yeah. It's perfect.
That was epic. But you got to be careful not to blow it up.
Yeah.
We're kind of in the middle of nowhere. That was epic, Evan. I think you're almost out. Your cable. Use the cable.
Oh, good. I'm like, is my drone falling out?
No.
That's good.
I don't know. I don't think so.
No, it's in my pocket still.
Okay, just slowly.
Yeah.
And we gotta go that way.
That's good.
Guys, okay, I just saw some droppings in the fall after that super hard section we did. That was like killer mud. It was started with a joke, but you know how it can deteriorate really rapidly. And then I saw a very clear fall mark. Brick. And droppings on the road. So I hope they will flee, but there's something probably a 10 centimeter, what is that, 3-4 inch fall in the middle of the mud, and droppings probably not that huge. So we find the GoPro. We did spot here in this coordinates a little something roaming around. Looked like bare droppings to me, the not so expert. And this was pretty crazy piece up there. I do hope we're not going to get more of that. That's just snow freshly melted and a bottom that's just totally washed out. And we could hardly find our way through. So I do hope that we can now... My bag's still on. Let's not worry about that for now. We've got somebody else to pick that up. So I hope we're going to get out on the cliff again. Where everything's dried up. This is really interesting going right now. This is forest. I just fell over, it's a mental hit. But it was just so slippery. And now we're just rolling downhill, but using a little bit of brake. Should probably engine brake. Yeah, here we go. Little engine braking. We'll be cheap with those. But let's hope this mud is over, because that was a killer. What I described earlier, those banks. There we go. So let's do an unedited cut as well, so you can see all the experience being built up here. Ah, more puddles. Okay. There we go, people. Brace ourselves for... Definitely don't want to burn your engine here, so... Nope, we're not out of our league. Now this looks doable. I think we can pull it out and slowly plow through this. Doable, we're up again, oh, man. Little mental challenge here in just keeping calm. You're all out here on your own, and we're I don't know how many miles in, probably over halfway now. Maybe we're on the descent. We've been seeing a couple of nice bear droppings with a, big fall in there. Ah, not so good. This is looking good though. And now you're just running scared and you're in mud mode. And let's go a little faster here. But I like the open spaces because it's dry. The sun is already beating it down. The bike's definitely proving to be slippery shit. The slippery shit is very slippery. And a massive lake. We do this one. I think we can do the left one. Roll through it. Do not drop it in the ship. Ah, success. These puddles are kind of doable. What you don't want to be doing is be on the bank with them. Because the bank is instantly. And you don't know, right? We don't know who's been over this. There might be a massive tree in the way, but at least we know we can get back. But that wasn't easy. I'd rather keep going forward. Well, they call it adventure biking. That's what we're doing. Sitting on the puddle, I think is doable. Let's go through this and this. Yeah, these are doable. Oh, big one coming. Well, I guess the
road is somewhere down there. I don't want to pull over, that's my biggest fear.
Let's just go through this.
That's a deep one. Holy! Well, something new around every corner, I guess. And we got sun again. This is a nice little meadow for a beer. We're also going very slowly through this section, I think, so just relax and keep rolling. Rabbit. And got about to here now. And we roll through. No idea what's underneath there. There isn't. Okay, maybe a little more challenge than what I was thinking up front, like this for instance, is the slipperiness without knobby tires, especially if I fall over we will definitely have a good ride. It's just massive snow puddles, and that's probably why June isn't a good idea, because even though the snow is perhaps gone, you are talking. I prevented the drainage of that giant puddle. Maybe I shouldn't have. Oh, little Elon Musk laugh. Elon is our god. Hey Elon, I'm riding a ICE, internal combustion engine, Euro. Don't try to be cool, Bardo, in this hectic situation. You can also bump the horn, make bears go, hey bear, hello bear. Hello bear. Hello bear. Hello bear. Am I still filming? Hello bear. Guess we can keep singing something like that, because the song's here. The meadows! We're alive! Where's the helicopter? In Vietnam it was 19. Hurrah! Oh bear! We made it! A puddle! No! Another puddle! I'm going left here. I don't want another puddle. Don't do it! Now your tires are obviously wet, so take that into account, dear fellow rider. Whoa! Dutchies inspired by other Dutchies doing insane things. Hey, this is on my bucket list. That's before you die. And with this thing, you die way faster. So you got your bucket list complete extremely early. It's a very short list. It's just one item. And there it ended. Ride whatever this mountain is. Whoa bear, whoa bear, whoa bear. Whoa bear, whoa bear. Oh man, I need to stop my GoPro for a minute. Whoa bear, whoa bear, whoa bear.
Yeah.
That was insane.
It was insane. I can't believe that. I'm fully soaked.
Look at our jeans. It's for 3 days. Oh yeah. Yeah, but then if you hit a rock,
I look like I'm in labor having a baby. I'm like this.
But then you can't react if there's a rock or anything.
I know. Well, I'm like, these are my 3 day jeans.
I hope we're through the thick of it now. I don't know. Let's have a look. Yeah. Oh wait. Oh wait. We're probably like halfway now.
Oh. Well.
It's longer than we thought. Filming here. Doing my Brett Tech impersonation. So often people ask me, what do I do, Brett, when I have to go over this kind of soft kind of gravelly rubble? So what I tell them is, do you like wiping your own butt? If so, definitely want to wear one of these. So here you go. As you go over this rubble, you definitely want to clamp down on your tank with your knees and just let the bike roll through it. You just let the bike do its work. Don't go like this. Don't stand there gnarly. Don't stand there and just peer out. Just grab the tank, loose hands, bend a little forward, and let the bike do its work. That's often what people ask me. So I tell them,
you like wiping your own butt, go get one of these caps. They're really good for that. Hey, Brett Tech. That was my Brett Tech impersonation. I love that guy. Love his movies. Love everything he does. I'm inspired by him, and I learned a lot already just by liking and subscribing. Brett Tech. I want to do a writing course with that guy. So what you do, basically, Bart, so most people ask me, you're from the Netherlands, can I do this type of driving? And I say, absolutely not. You've got fear of heights. You do not want to be doing this type of riding if you're from the Netherlands. So if you're from the Netherlands, I recommend a dyke that's like 6 meters tall, and just you use that slippery grass to slide up and down on, and that's about all you can take with your mental state, living like 7 meters below sea level. And here's a crossing. So what do people do when they reach a crossing? Often the wrong thing. So here's what I would do. You definitely want to stand in the saddle, clamp that tank, hold your butt, put your cap on, and here we go over the picking. So what do you do? Often people ask me, what do you do when you gotta go over this stupid rubble? What you do, you stand on the bike, even if you're from the Netherlands, you just stand on your bike, you put your cap back on, you basically roll, holy moly, this is a view! Put your cap back on, and then we gotta go for some hoe. There's a cliff, Dutchman on a cliff. The Brat Tech told me to never look down, just keep rolling, just keep climbing further, and I hope there's no more mud inside, because mud scares the heebie-jeebies out of me, people. And if we don't make it across, put flowers. And that was my session, Brett Tech. Let me quickly take my helmet off, put my cap on, and here we are, people. Time for a break. Dude! So that was my Brett Tech impersonation, but now suddenly we came upon this view that is just time to really take your helmet off. There's another 4,000er. So we're now maybe on the crest. Rainier is very far away. It'll be all the way around those mountains to get there again. And then here we have an epic shot of Kevin. We got these little flowers everywhere. I have a little bit of something.
I guess we did.
These are the Edelweiss. Don't roll down the hill if you get off.
Yeah, I was like, I don't think I'll use the kickstand right here because that'll be the end of this motorcycle.
Okay, then we do ride the duo again. So maybe put it a little further up.
I'm not setting it down. I'm just gonna hang under it.
Okay, you're not taking a break. Oh, here goes our buddy. So I think I say we keep going.
Yeah, I mean I'm just in it for the scenery, so.
Yeah.
Well, you still got that and got time to get the rain.
I'm in it for the mud.
Yeah.
Look at his meadows. This is like the gladiator scene where you're like, oh. This is for Mazzaro's. Robert, I'm the gladiator. Me and flowers. Nowhere else to go. And here we find the impeccable mountain lavender, ladies and gentlemen. It smells completely different than what I expected. And I've never seen this plant before. And with that, I sign off. This is David Attenborough in beautiful meadows. Thank you very much. We always have to do the flowery shot. And go through these. The hell are alive with the sound of roaring motorcycles. Oh, and here, ladies and gentlemen, on our left, we have the impressive Mount Rainier, and of course, there's Stig DahlQuist right in front of it, breaking another pair of glasses.
Smashed the other side out.
So. Smashed the other side out.
Now it's official.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is what a triumph, what's it called? Royale Enfield. In Paris, they call it the Cheese Royale.
Oh, yeah.
So how you like the show so far, Kevin DahlQuist?
I'm just here for the Royale with cheese.
I thought you were here for the scenery.
Oh, yeah, that too.
I have not found the McDonald's just yet.
Well, there's probably a Starbucks up here somewhere.
I think so. If not, we definitely have to get that organized.
Yeah.
Because I miss my styrofoam cup blowing in the wind majestically across the meadows. Look at that awesome. I'm not going to clean this.
This looks very nice right now. I'm going to use some gray paint and replicate each of these dots and freeze them in time, like tears in the rain. Pupillary dilation, involuntary blush response. We call it void comp for short. This is my Blade Runner quote. Do you like our owl? Must be expensive. Of course it is. Is it artificial? And here we, I'm not gonna go down here. This scares the Hebe. Don't put a Dutch guy on a cliff. Okay, and with that, we're signing off. There's a cloud. Kevin.
Oh, wow.
We're screwed, man.
Cloud.
The snow is coming in. We gotta make shelter.
Yeah, I hear there's that snow thunder.
Look, even here they have flowers, you see, in between these rocks. And then you have to make sure with your motorbike tire you go over this one instead, that you don't go over this one, and save the little tree. Save the animals.
Save the flowers.
This is going to be my very long podcast. Oh no, there's a stain on the lens again. Oh, there's a fly at my fire. Your headlight's on.
I know, but I'm charging my drone.
Oh, okay.
I wish I could turn it off, but...
This is the I'm making some tea shot.
Yeah, I got a picture of you doing it.
So I just concocted for Kevin a cup of tea with literally the good shit.
Oh,
this is epic. We're gonna fly down this mountain. So man, oh look at this.
Ah,
it's Earl Grey.
So classy.
So then I gave him a urine sample.
That's right. I told him I gotta remember to hold my pinky up.
How's your pinky up during this tea ceremony? Tibetan. How does that smell?
It smells like.
It's not a bad urine sample,
no,
is it?
No, it seems like you're clean. I think you passed. I think you're good work here.
Oh, so good.
On the mountain.
Oh, I'm burning my lips here. So we're here on the top of a mountain making a cup of tea in epic conditions. On some of the good shit. It's a tea named, they named Earl Grey. So good, it was so good.
Cheers to the good shit.
We're drinking tea on the mountain.
Good and hot. Man, that burner is really no joke.
It's insane. You know what? It's the altitude, isn't it? Doesn't water cook quicker here?
I think that's true.
We gotta go a little higher, man.
Yeah.
No, it's the altitude. I do have some altitude sickness. It's called fear of heights.
Fear of falling down.
Fear of... Okay, so we're in an area with a lot of rocks, the downside on the way to Nile. Still got a ways to go here. Oh. So if you look at the whole map, still have a ways to go. Wow. Let me see, 3 miles. Yeah, anyway, we just have to keep trucking. And I think there's Kevin, so I'm gonna put it back on my head and keep going.
That was embarrassing.
What happened?
I just laid the bike over.
It was shitty, right? It was very shitty.
I just got too wiggly and then you're gonna blame the tea.
I had it too. It's very, very rocky. Very rocky there.
Yeah. So I don't have a good reason why I fell. I was just like,
you picked it up. Yeah. I saw something, but we're ready to go.
Yep.
Okay. Let's go. Well, it's rock heaven here for sure. And hot. It's getting hot now. So they warned us that the downhill is very rocky, and indeed the last part we did was just trail riding almost. Trials meaning very slow rocks. This is much better already. I didn't have the camera on, but a couple of our ATV encounters. Right, and we're back in rock territory. So here you see a little bit what those rocks are like. And here I think I can avoid them. Look at those flowers. It must be shaky with the camera on it. This is epic riding.
And we do a whole bear. Whoa bear. Whoa bear. You see droppings? Go whoa bear. Whoa bear. Some nice meadows for a bear. Oh, bank corner. Woo. And then try to avoid flowers. More epic meadows here. Just wanna try to gun it over these stones. More stones. Holy macaroni, man. Definitely have to ride it before. Oh, look at this hill. This was years ago. So if those little hills are slippery, we gotta really look up. See all these rock beds? Shitty. I hope you don't get a puncture on this stuff. Maybe slow down a little again. We're at the point where becoming trial riding again. Trials riding is just slow. Second gear. Find a gear here. You hear me? I feel my toes getting hit by the front. Let's go left here. Up this little embankment. Stones, man. The road is made of stones. It's definitely not made with bikes in mind. It's made with. Whoa, bear. Oh, an endless road of rocks. I guess this is what itchy boots does for a living. Insane, man. Okay, I'm gonna slow it down here. Just a little bit. Looks a little bit better there on the left, actually. I think it's suddenly you're in a puddle with knee deep. Okay. I think this is the last video, so probably want to stop the camera right now. I'm just going to stop the camera. Well, I just took a dip in the river here and we made it back, so now it's on to some food. Food! What a view. Hey, that waterfall was cool over there.
Yeah, there were a lot of them right in a row.
Yeah. How far is it?
All right, I'll save a little battery for Rainier.
Yeah, Rainier.